Hello, everybody, what's going on? This is Will here, and we're back with another part of Tales of Phantasia. In the last episode, we explored the future of the world for the first time. We came across a few monsters, discovered the whereabouts of a new summon we need to get in order to fly over to Alvinista. So, yeah. I didn't really know where to go, though, to find this new summon, Volt, that we need to power these, like, air bird things that we can fly. But, looked at the walkthrough, and apparently this cave actually is where we need to go. But it's, yeah, since it's in the future, it's actually, like, a completely different place, which is kind of confusing. Alright, so, before I even go into this battle, let's scan the hell out of these guys. Alright, not much health. Alright, okay. Oh lord. Hopefully that doesn't kill them. Okay, no, they don't have any weaknesses or anything. Well, that's kind of lame. Yeah, okay, yeah, use your hammer. Oh, it didn't work, though. Well, it didn't work on the skull guy. Nothing wrong with that, though, because now he's dead. There we go. Kume leveled up. Wow, really? Really, Kume leveled up. Yeah, look at that. Jeez, man. Our party is leveling up really quickly now. Feels great, actually. We got some lavender, and we got some lavender. Well, that's pretty good. Apparently, what you can also do with lavender here, you can actually use rune bottles to power them up and make red lavender. And I can only assume that you can also do this with pretty much every other, you know, every other of the herbs. There we go. So I'm just going to give them both to Wheel, and I'll be just that much stronger, which is fantastic. Always good to have lots of rune bottles on hand. They're so handy. Get it? It's like on hand, so hand. It's funny. Okay. I don't know what this is, so that's good. Do we need the Sorcerer's Ring, maybe? I don't really know. I'm just guessing. Mystical Rune. Yeah, okay. Kume doesn't get hit too much, so we'll just put the Sorcerer's Ring on you. We have to, like, light up something with this Sorcerer's Ring. Yeah, look at that. It's exactly what we have to do. Grimorum? What the hell is a Grimorum? I'm just gonna guess it's a book. Dude, I'm a freaking genius. Alright. Well, there we go. Clarth, there's your Grimorum. You got a new book. Hopefully it does you for the next, like, a million years, because we don't seem to get many books for poor Clarth. What are we fighting this time? Bone bows. That sounds weird. Sounds like you're saying something with a speech impediment. Bone bow. Alright, let's see what these guys are like. Okay. Average amount of health. Oh, I don't know what this is gonna do, though. Okay. No, stop, stop, stop. Okay. And no weaknesses again? These guys all seem rather plain, don't they? Look at that. Man, this is a freaking easy place so far. Wow. Oh, let's, we'll identify this bow while we're at it. Just while we still got the ball rolling here. Where'd I put those rune bottles? Are there. Da-da-da-da. A short bow. Well, that was really, useful. We needed that, definitely. Oh, this is a door, too. With freaking nothing here. That's good. Actually, I'll have to come back to that room, I'm sure. There's probably something very significant there. Ooh, this place feels more and more like a maze as I keep going through here, though. I don't like that, because I'm not good with mazes. I'm very bad with them, actually. What am I looking for? Holy bottle. Should have restocked on those, too. Ah, frig. Not very prepared. Whoa, so what's that do? I don't even know what that does. There's a secret passage on the right side of the room with the stairs. Okay. Oh, okay. Come on. Frig. Ah, God. Oh, I see. I think. Maybe I don't. I don't get it. You can't move these things. Right? No. Doesn't look like it. Weird. Well, okay, we'll come here later then. Nothing wrong with, you know, backtracking. Holy cow. Jeez, I'm glad that these things are freaking... freaking easy to kill, because they're just annoying otherwise. Look at these poor guys. Man, these guys are just getting... Oh my god, torn apart. I didn't even have to do anything right there. Clarth and I leveled up. I got something right there. I'm not quite sure what that was. Alright. I'm sorry, Rao, but I'm getting rid of your hammerhead thing because it's freaking annoying. Items. Oh, another question mark bow. Let me guess, it's another short bow. That's gonna be freaking useless. Well, let's go on through here then. Oh man, what's this? Orange gummy found, but you can't carry anymore. Well, that's good. That's fantastic. Shield ring found, okay. And a life bottle was found, but we can't use it. What's a shield ring? That's a new item. This magic ring creates an invisible shield around the wearer. Oh, whoa, that's kind of cool. Alright, so I can equip this to someone. It probably really, yeah. It would really benefit me to have this. Oh, I can't. Oh, I see. Only Clarth can use it, right? Right? Am I right? No. Who uses... I don't get it. Oh, wait. Is it a shield item, maybe? It is. Look at that. Is it only Clarth that can use that? Oh, no. Okay. Different people can use it. Well, that's great. And I assume that... Yeah, it's not for me. It's for anyone else but me. Alright, well... You know what? Kume's got the least... I don't know who to give it to. This is such a pivotal thing here. Okay, well, Rao's always right behind me, so maybe I should give it to her. Because... Yeah, actually, that would be good, because she's probably the least shielded right now, because... Clarth always has those, like, other defense rings that he wears as accessories, so... This would be most beneficial, just kind of spread out the protection and stuff. Always thinking ahead. These freaking salamanders, I don't understand. I don't understand what they're for. It's just really weird that they just walk around. Just crawl all over the floor and stuff. It's freaking messed up. Alright, I think we're going in circles, aren't we? We are. Well, okay. Well, I went in... Oh, God, I don't freaking know, man. This is such a disorienting area. Alright, well, I think we need to get there. That's where we need to be. I would assume that we want to be wherever that thing in the corner was. But I don't really know how to get there. Okay, what's this? There's a secret passage on the right side of the room with the stairs. Okay. Oh, man, we got... Man, you should have seen how much gold we got from that fight. Holy cow. It was like 4,000-something. Man, we are... bringing in the mad stacks of cash. Alright, so, they said there's a secret passage in the room with the stairs. Okay. Let's take a look around here. Nothing here. That's certainly stairs right there. Oh, that place locks up, though. Okay, so there's some kind of design technique used here to trip you up. A secret path. Oh, that's sneaky right there. Holy cow. I don't even know what that does, but it does something. Okay, so we pressed down that switch, so what does that mean? It obviously changed something in the layout of this place, or it unlocked something, maybe. Probably unlocked something down here. I would bet. I would assume, no? Nothing? Really? Oh, it opened this door down here. Okay. Yeah, let's pull the lever. I don't even know what it does, but... Okay. So it goes from being vertical to being horizontal. So, oh God. I'm not even gonna bother with the arcanes, because the skulls are so much worse. They pick on poor Kume. Yeah, there you go. You guys just worry about those two. There you go. Easy enough. Okay, so now that we did that, something's got to have happened because we pushed, or because we turned that switch thing. Something has to have happened. That's so weird. Such a weird way of saying that. Alright, holy bottle. Oh man, look at all these bats. All these Zubats. Look at them all. Oh, I see. Change the layout of how the electricity would run through the current. Okay. So we found an apple and some bread. I would only assume that they're very dirty old pieces of bread and a very old dirty apple. So that's always good. Alright, yeah, let's get some food into us. We kind of need some, need some reassurance here. Some regeneration of health would be nice outside of all this. Anything we need to heal? Yeah, Kume's got a few scrapes and bruises. Bread, boar roast. Okay, well, it's better than nothing. 650 food. Not too bad. For just being out and about without buying anything. Alright, what's this? There's a secret on this floor. The rest is scratched out. It's totally illegible. Well, that's good. It's broken. What the heck? What? Oh. Alright. What did I just do? I didn't want to do that. Oh! What? Oh, what a dick move! Okay, so I'm back where I was before. And, whoa. This place is certainly a bit more complicated than it looks. Alright, there's a sign right here, so I'll try to read this, get around the teleporter. Oh, yeah, thanks. Thanks for putting the emergency exit sign farther away from it. God, because like that's going to be the first thing I'm going to see. I'm not going to check the freaking sign first, because it's farther away. That was totally intentional. That was made just to annoy people. Alright, there's a left side over here too, so let's see. Okay. Alright. Well. No secret passages. Nothing, really. There's not really much of anything around here. Oh, Lord. Okay, I think I see what I gotta do. Okay. So, don't worry, I'm not actually gonna be using Lance right now. I'm just gonna be, taking these from him here. Here, have a heavy stone. Carry that rock with you everywhere. Form. Change. There we go. Alright, I'm thinking what we might have to do, I'm not, like, completely sure, but I think what we might have to do is, bonus TP, protected from, okay. I just need you to hold this nice and quick. Clarth, there you go. Alright. I'm thinking we need to use the running. Oh, so close. All right, we got this. Okay, wait. Oh, you son of a gun! Ugh, man, it's getting really frustrating to have to do all these puzzles, but like have all these encounters at the same time. Yeah, look at that. Got in. You feel an invisible barrier here. Oh, all right. So I guess we're just gonna go in here. What's in here? What the heck, man? Man, this place is so complicated. Ooh, a sylph broom. Hey, Kume, do you want a sylph broom here? Have a sylph broom. I don't even know if this will be very good for you. Because it's wind. I don't know. This place seems to have a wind theme, even though it's like lightning. I don't understand that. Yeah, pull that lever. There we go. Something moved right there. Oh, of course. Holy cow, man. This wouldn't be such a bad dungeon if we weren't just hit with random encounters all the time. Jeez, man. They seem so, like, overpowering. Like, I know that they're not, but... jeez. It's probably no different from all the other dungeons, but it just feels like we're getting jumped by enemies a lot more. I don't even know what that means. What does that mean? It's broken. Thanks. Thanks a lot. I still don't really get it, but... Okay, well, I got through there. Feel invisible barrier. I don't understand that. There was nothing else up here, right? Yeah, it was just that one lever. Unless that one lever does something. Come on, Will, you gotta use your brain. Your brain has to be used. And it's not being used at the moment because I don't have any idea what I'm doing. Yeah, I want to see what this thing does here. Alright, yeah, pull the lever. I don't know what it does, but... Oh, wow. It makes this thing last a lot longer. That's what it appears to do. Come on. Ooh, yeah. Freaking right. Okay, I figured this room out. Alright, there's gotta be more encounters in this place than usual, because I'm already getting used to the attack patterns of them. And it's only been, like, 20 minutes. I've gotta be getting used to these guys by now. Alright, gotta heal up a bit. I'm a bit wounded. Rao, come on. You know you want to. Thank you. And there we go. And, man, yeah, we're all pretty beaten up from that. Alright, you feel an invisible barrier. Okay. So we'll just go here. Okay, here we go. I found a save point, which is a good way of knowing that we've made some reasonable progress and that it's a good time to end the video. So, I hope you all have a very good life. Or afterlife, if you're skulls who keep ambushing and picking on Kume and Rao, looking to kill me in the next episode. They're a bunch of bullies. Makes me angry. Peace.